This is VOA News. Reporting by remote, I'm David Byrd. President Joe Biden is urging Americans to rally behind his plan for fighting the coronavirus pandemic this winter. AP's Sagar Magani reports.
Experts say cases will keep rising.
So we need to be ready.
On a visit to the National Institutes of Health, the president laid out a five-part plan focused on booster shots and testing.
It doesn't include shutdowns or lockdowns,
which he says should unite Americans who have too often been divided through the pandemic. The president's urging the 100 million eligible Americans who have not yet been boosted to get the extra shot. He's also tightening testing requirements for people coming to the U.S. and wants to require private insurers to cover the cost of at-home COVID-19 tests. Sagar Magani, Washington.
German Chancellor Angela Merkel says unvaccinated people across her country will soon be excluded from non-essential stores, restaurants, and sports and cultural venues as Germany struggles against the coronavirus. AP's Charles de Ledesma reports.
Speaking after a meeting with regional leaders, Merkel says people who aren't vaccinated will be excluded from non-essential stores, cultural and recreational venues, and Parliament will consider a general vaccine mandate as part of an effort to curb coronavirus infections that again topped 70,000 newly confirmed cases in a recent 24-hour period. Merkel adds the measures are necessary in light of concerns that hospitals in Germany could become overloaded with people suffering COVID-19 infections, which are more likely to be serious in those who haven't been vaccinated. I'm Charles de Ledesma.
On Wall Street, the Dow was up 1.82%, the S&P gained 1.42%, the Nasdaq rose by 0.83%. This is VOA News. Russia is voicing concern about a possible escalation of fighting in the separatist conflict in eastern Ukraine, while the United States is warning Moscow to stay away. We get more from AP's Ben Thomas.
Ukraine and Western officials have expressed worries that a Russian troop buildup near Ukraine could herald an invasion. But Moscow insists it has no such intention and has accused Ukraine and the West of having their own aggressive designs. Secretary of State Antony Blinken calls that Russian disinformation.
Ukraine is in no way posing a threat to Russia or seeking a confrontation that would justify a Russian military intervention.
Blinken met with Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov in Stockholm Thursday, expressing
our deep concerns and our resolve to hold Russia responsible for its actions.
For his part, Lavrov warned Russia would respond in kind to any Western sanctions, but welcomed the U.S. offer to join diplomatic efforts toward peace in eastern Ukraine. I'm Ben Thomas.
Migrants seeking to enter the United States will again have to stay in Mexico as they await immigration hearings, as the Biden administration reluctantly announced plans Thursday to comply with a court order and accept conditions set out by Mexico for resuming the Trump-era policy. At a news conference, White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki said the administration had no choice but to reinstate the program for now.
We are in a situation where we're under a court, abiding by a court ruling. And so that is what we are working to implement at this point in time.
Mexico's foreign relations secretary said Mexico would allow returns beginning next week in light of U.S. concessions for humanitarian reasons and for temporary stays. Revival of the Remain in Mexico policy comes under a court order, even as the Biden administration maneuvers to end it in a way that survives legal scrutiny. The number of Americans applying for unemployment benefits rose last week, even though the U.S. job market has been rebounding from last year's coronavirus recession. The Labor Department reported jobless claims climbed by 28,000 to 222,000 from the previous week's 52-year low of 194,000. The four-week average of claims, which smooths out week-to-week up and down movement, fell below 239,000, a pandemic low. Overall, 2 million Americans were receiving traditional jobless benefits for the week that ended November 20th. That was down by 107,000 from the week before. You can find more on our website, voanews.com. You can also follow us on the VOA mobile app. Reporting by remote, I'm David.